was always on fire. Our house, our dreams. We were dancing on a wire, reckless, it seemed. We found holes in these walls. We like what we saw. Seems so strong until it falls. The final straw.
So we want to test our heat treat. So what I did, I ran it through two cycles. That's what 1080 steel calls for. So you get it up above magnetic, about 1500 degrees twice. You quench it twice. But now this file, if we did it right, should just kind of skate across there without cutting in. And that's what it's doing. The only shininess I'm getting is where I have scale on it. That's it. Now if I go to this end, which I didn't, wasn't worrying about hardening this end so much. Same pressure. Bites right in. You can see that? See, that's shiny, but anywhere we go here, on that cutting edge, that's how you know you got it nice and hard. So, we're getting there. We're going to send this out to Steven here, hopefully by next week, I'm hoping. So, we'll see what happens, but we'll do the best we can to get it out quickly. Well, just a really fast update tonight. I want to let you guys know what was going on with the draw knife. We've had a bit of rain here today, so there's been no timber frame in the last couple of days. Hopefully the weekend it looks like it's going to turn around, and hopefully we can get back on that pretty heavily. We only have 8 timbers left that we have to cut joints in, and I'd really like to get it done, get that last gable end up, so on and so forth. So here's where we stand right now. All right. All we have to do is a finish grind on it, the polishing, put the handles on. Of course, I've got to take it inside, put it in the oven for about an hour, hour and a half at about 400. I think I'm gonna go like 425 on it, and then we can get it tempered. Now we could do this with a torch, but what I like about an oven is it's so controlled when you do that. It's very controlled. The handles, I'm not as worried about being hard. I'd rather have those kind of springy. I mean, right now, I could probably break this if I try to flex it too much. She's good and hard there, especially on that cutting edge, and that's where we really want it. In the heat treat, we got just a tiny bit of warpage. Not a big deal. There's no warpage on the cutting edge. It looks like I just have to take one of these handles here and thin it down a little bit. It's really not so much a warp as it is my grinding, but not a big deal, because like I said, this part, I'm not worried about getting this one a little too warm and taking the temper out of it. That's not a big deal at all, but like I said, the next step is to take this in, put it in the oven, and temper this baby. And hopefully we should be ready to send it out pretty quick. Now, You notice I didn't do the standard draw knife handles on this, and after making that debarking knife and doing the handles the way I did those, I tell you what, I really liked the control of that. I really liked it. It's a lot easier on the hands and the wrists too, because you're not at an awkward angle trying to do this. It's more naturally how your hands fit. So we'll see how this works out when we do some other stuff, but I'm kind of excited to get this out to Steven and see how him and his son like it. I'm actually really excited to get this thing out here. So anyway, hope you enjoyed it. I know it was a real short one, but don't you worry. You got plenty more timber framing coming up and projects beyond. So have a good night, folks. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you on the next one.